Seven brothers began grappling at basically birth. By age three, he was grappling with Horion, Holz, and his younger brother Hickson. By the time Hoist was born, Helson was already defending the family name in the streets.
Representing Helson, representing Brazil, representing you, represent everybody. So if I have to fight against Jensen, Egon, or another Hawaiian, I give the honor. I fight against anyone. Show me the money, I show you the show.
That's what you want, a new try now. Come to me, come to you.
Thank you. 究極の護身術、最強の格闘技であるグレイシー柔術。その中にはエリオ・グレイシーが作り上げた数々の秘技がある。エリオ・グレイシーには7人の息子と2人の娘がいる。彼らは父親の背中を見て育ち、ほとんどがグレイシー柔術を受け継いでいる。
You're going to have to hold it like this. Okay, that's going to take right there. Push that knee right onto my hip. Very good. Now, you put this. Don't need to resist. I'm just going to show you the form, okay? One, and you got this right. One, two.
The camera.
He's saying that in your case, which you know, that he changed a few things when he was passing the guard. Helps him close all those chances that he had because he knows what you do on top of you. You know, and those are, you know, the advanced parts of his details.
Keep your balance. Okay, because
Filio says this is the best class he's seen for the shortest time that the student's been training.
You guys, this guy's 5 days.
This is named everybody. No, you guys are just coming by home. Here. Nice place for everybody. Come and see what you do. So, hold everybody. Custa caro, hein? Vai custar caro essa foto.
Diz a eles que a minha viagem do Brasil aqui foi regiamente paga e
recompensada. He said that his long trip from Brazil to here has really been well paid off from everybody. You know, he's just really happy to be here.
For jiu-jitsu champion Helson Gracie, putting other people down is not a case of bad manners, but the mark of a methodical mentor who believes in building from a well-grounded foundation.
Grab my neck,
okay.
And then you stand up,
and then I'm doing like this.
Pretty much 90% of the fights going to the ground. That's hard to stop when one person intentional want to take to the ground. He want to clinch you. It's hard to stop no going to the ground because he trapped your legs, and then basically the fight going to the ground.
Jiu-jitsu itself means soft ground work, implying that through body leverage in a prone position, one can most effectively soften up an aggressor. And flanked by a famous fighting family who've mopped the mats with other macho martial artists, the battling Brazilian is not lying when he says his singular style is inherently empowering.
Jiu-jitsu gives you control the whole fight. What you can see, I take people down, I hold, I defense my neck, I keep protecting myself to not get caught. And the way, they're gonna give me some chance, the chance is gonna show up, and then he's gonna be caught sooner or later.
I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna come here, take it down, and I'm gonna come this.
The Gracie grip has left a distinctive mark on Georgetown's Jay Dennis, who's opened jiu-jitsu schools here in the Lowcountry based on the concept that brains can beat brawn.
Most people are not 6'5", 300-pound monsters. This art is geared for a small person like myself, I'm no huge person, to be able to be effective against a bigger guy, 175, 180, 200, 250, with little strength. If you use strength, you're doing the techniques incorrectly. You don't want to use a lot of pushing and pulling and muscle power like wrestling would do, or judo. It's more just using your hips a lot or using submission holds correctly.
In winning a host of international competitions that include the Ultimate Fighting Championships, Helson and his family have proven that body leverage and flexibility can overcome brute strength with a technique that deflects and disarms the most aggressive grips, kicks, chokes, or punches, often by using the momentum of the menace itself.
When you do this, basically the pressure is right over your elbow, forces wrist up. See the pressure coming here. This thing press your elbow down and force up.
And wrapping much like a constricting snake to form choking and breaking holds, the struggle is soon over.
Helson's like an anaconda, man. He's going to squeeze the breath out of you.
The gist of jiu-jitsu greatness is the fluidity of movement that has kept Helson undefeated in professional events. Yet its popularity seems to derive its strength from the fact that you can learn martial mayhem without breaking bones or bruising egos.
Right here. Yes, yes. Okay.
While taking on Helson, even in controlled conditions, can have its stressful situations, it beats the professional pummeling. And for folks who would really prefer not to fight, it gives them a much better chance to hold their ground.
In the wintertime, not sure what the thrill is going to be. I wake up in the morning, ready to hit the road. Don't forget your load. We're cruising down the highway. We're jamming to the reggae beat in the tropical heat. Not sure. What a sight to see. Not sure where the waves are mean. It's like a washing machine.
Pequeno só podia dar nisso.
Esse nós é mais rápido. Nossa,
cara. Um cara com menos velocidade, de repente é pior.
Yes!
Um cara mais conhecido. Saulo sabe daquela. Agora eu não sei se o Saulo sabe daquela pega do braço, sacando o pescoço, ou se ele está com o braço,
pegar o braço. Mas o que acontece se eu quero que a gente fale? Eu te puxo pra cá, ó. Pra onde é que vai rodar?
Rodado, né? Porque essa perna foi mal.
Honor for us, have him here. He be a part of the team, like he always doing for me. I feel him like a follow the next generation is gonna be like a new Dixon Grace because nobody have his weight in the family. He keep the title, the open divisions, and he pretty much gonna be just like Dixon, coming the same way. And then I have his results in the competition. He's gonna be like the one who's gonna represent the Grace Jiu-Jitsu for a while. And then that's his time. I will appreciate he be trained with us. I feel Saul like my brother, and then relate with him. I'm very comfortable. And then I'm gonna send him to doing class in my associations too. I just deal with him. He come at least 3 times a year in Hawaii, help me business, help me associations, help me prepare you guys better.
The intention is to promote the fights in Hawaii. It's a good place to visit, a good place to work. I met people, everybody's nice. So. It's a pleasure for me to represent Helson, represent Brazil, represent Graceful. You, represent everybody. So if I have to fight against Enzo, Igor, or another Hawaiian, I can do not. I fight against anyone. Show me the money, I show you the show. That's what I want to do.
Okay, yes. I want to say thanks to Saul again. It's like my...
Tell us a little bit more about you and Hixon. When you guys first rolled? How many years ago? How many times? So maybe tell us a little bit more about Hixon, the legend.
My first contact with Hixon, I was brown belt. Was in Brazil, and he came to train. And I heard a lot of things about Hixon, but I never had the opportunity to roll with him. So I thought that I was good, but when I rolled against him, I felt like I was a white belt because he rolled with all the black belts almost an hour. Then he gave me the opportunity to train, he made me tap 10, 12, I don't know how many times. So it was good because I can feel the pressure. And then he back to America. When I come to LA in 1996, I was black belt. And he just came from Kauai. He was on vacation. And he was seeing the Pan American. He invited a couple Brazilian black belts to train me. Boleta, Jamelão, Alexandre Paiva, Fábio Gugel, Royler, and a couple more guys, and make everybody tap. And was impression. All the best Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu guys in shape to the tournament. And Hixon was on vacation. And he put the gi on to train fast, make everybody tap. Nobody can contest this. So. And the last time I saw Hixon was in the last Pan American Champion in Hawaii. I had the opportunity to train against him again. And it was good because now I know that my level is better. I'm more close to him. And it's a pleasure for me. Can continue training and give him a hard time because everybody that don't know Hixon don't believe what he can do. So I'm a lucky guy because Now I know what he can do it. And that's it. I want to see he fight again because I believe on him. I believe in his technique. And I'm his fan. That's it.
Tell us between him and Sperry. Between Hickson and Sperry, who do you
Hickson,
tell us a little bit?
Hickson don't care about points, about sweeps, about. He only want to make the guy tap. So, if we put a Hickson to fight a tournament with the time, with advantage, with points, it's hard for Hickson back to compete because he don't compete since 1985, so it's a long time. But I put all my money, all my jiu-jitsu, my belt, no time limit. Until that, he beat everybody. Everybody. He make everybody tap. No problem. No problem. But with time limit, it's hard for him.
So the recent challenge from Sperry, or Hickson challenging Sperry, is really nonsense, considering that Hickson is definitely a level above, huh?
Yeah. For
Sperry's a champion, but he's
Sperry fight against Hickson. He has to beat everybody in Brazil. He don't fight against me. He don't fight against plenty of champions of Brazil. With Fabio Gurgel, he didn't fight against Travin, and Hickson make everybody tap. So doesn't make sense. He fought against Hoyler, that is almost the halfway of him. So, he don't prove not. If he wanna fight with a good guy, fight against me. He run off me 2 times. I'm waiting for him, I'm ready. I have maybe 40 pounds less than him, but I don't care. My heart is bigger than him. I know that. That's it.
You're gonna meet him in the Worlds? You're gonna, the 99 World Champion?
For sure.
When does this take place?
Rio.
September Rio. Or?
July.
In July.
25, 26, 27 of July.
When are you going to be back in Hawaii?
Probably September.
September.
Fight.
Yes. This is going to be a Vale Tudo?
Yeah. A Vale Tudo. Going to continue teaching.
Will this be your first professional Vale Tudo?
What? This one?
Yes, no, coming up, September.
I did in 1996, a Vale Tudo against a Kung Fu guy in Brazil. I beat him 1 minute and 30 seconds, and I don't give one punch. That was it.
Thank you, Saulo, very much.
Thank you, man, appreciate it.
May the God be with you, bro. You're an excellent fighter.
See you.